Hello everyone. I thought it was time to create a resin geode on a wooden artboard again. And to make this resin geode, I'm going to use different techniques. I'm also going to use some texture because I want to have a nice textured look to it. And I'm mainly going to use my own pigments in some nice colors. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin in this case, or acrylics, mixed media, alcohol ink, I have a lot of tutorials. Consider to subscribe and don't forget to click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So what I already mentioned, I'm going to create a resin geode on a wooden artboard again. And I sealed my artboard with two layers of gesso and two layers of acrylic paint. I always do that, the front side, but also the back and the sides, because there is always air in MDF. And if you don't seal it well enough, then the air will come up, will rise to the top, and then you have all air bubbles in your resin, so that's not nice. So the first technique I'm going to use is the bubbles technique. And for this technique, I'm using a fast setting resin, in this case the Stone Coat Quick Coat. I had some left, so that's why I'm using that. It has a working time of 15 minutes. And to create these bubbles, you also need some dish soap. It doesn't matter what dish soap you use, but you make the bubbles with your dish soap and you put it on top of the resin, and then you can create a nice texture of the bubbles. So if you use another resin, then you need to check out your working time, because you need to add the this soap at the end of the working time, because then the bubbles will stay in the resin. Because yeah, I had some Stone Coat, but if you have another one with a longer working time, then you need to wait until you before you add the bubbles on top of the resin. So I'm further ahead now, I'm almost at the end of the working time, and now I'm going to add the bubbles I made with the dish soap. I'm adding it on top. Yeah, and I also drawn some lines on my wooden artboard, and that's only for me where I want to have the colors and the textures. So this wooden artboard is 40 centimeters, so not that large, but I think it's a nice size. And you leave the bubbles on until they are almost gone. And then after that you need to clean it, and then it's done. So the bubbles are dry, and now I'm going to start on my first layer. In the middle I'm pouring some clear resin. I'm using the Art Pro resin, because in the middle I want to have some texture, and I'm using fire glass in a nice pink shade. So not too much, only a little bit of the fire glass, because I also want to add some glass glitter. There you can see it. This is a nice color. It's the seashell color. All the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites. Adding a little bit more clear. Yeah, you can't see the texture of the bubbles that well, But at the end of the video, I'm showing you all a close-up, and then you can see the texture much better. It's really nice. This fire glass is also very nice. It has a mirror side, and the other side is the color side. It's a nice pink shade, because I'm also going to use some pink colors. So we are a little bit further in the process, and now I'm going to pour some white next to the bubbles. And this is the white paste of Resin Pro. And this will be my base layer, because this diode will get at least 4 layers. So hopefully the white will shine through. And with my stirring stick, I push it against the bubbles, the bubble effects. Yeah, and I always have so much fun when I create a geode. And the artboard I'm using is also from Resin Pro. You can get them in several sizes. What I already mentioned, this one is 40 centimeters, but you can also get them in 60 centimeters, sorry. And they are very nice. They have a ring on the back side, so you can hang it very easy on your wall. Yeah, and what I forgot to mention is that I colored the bubbles, the resin. I used a white paste and also one of my own natural mica pigments that I'm testing is the Aurora Pink. And this color is the Cotton Candy, also one of my own pigments. Very nice pink shade. And with my stirring stick, I push it against the white. Yeah, and I'm adding 4 layers because I also want to create some depth. And hopefully I will get that. Using the heat gun to remove some air bubbles. I'm also adding some gold next to the fire glass and the glass glitter. It's the a nice powder pigment, also from Resin Pro, and this pigment will rise to the top and flow on top of your resin, so that's really nice. But in this case, I'm adding it in between the bubbles that I created and the flyer glass. So we are a little bit further in the process. Yeah, I'm not going to show you the whole process, only steps of it, but enough so you can see how I created this geode. Because otherwise I would get a very long video. This video is already 40 minutes because I want to show you as much as I can. So hopefully I can inspire you all to also create a geode and use different techniques that I show you all. Pushing the gold against the bubbles. And then I'm almost done with the first layer. And then I need to let it dry before I can work on it again. Yes, I'm going to use a gilding liquid, and with a foam brush I'm adding it on top of the bubbles so that only the higher parts of the bubbles will get this golden look or color. So very carefully and soft I'm brushing it onto the bubbles. Yeah, and I'm using a gilding liquid that is has a not a watery viscosity, but it's thicker, and I think that is much better to use, because otherwise the gilding liquid will stream into your bubble, and that's not nice. I only want it on top. Yeah, you can see it, the consistency of the gilding liquid. It's much thicker than water. It's like a cream or a paste. Also, the link to the gilding liquid is in the description box. Almost done with the gilding liquid, and then I need to also let this dry before I can add more resin. So the gilding liquid is dry. Now I'm going to start on layer 2, and for this layer I'm using a thicker resin, also from Resin Pro. Because I'm going to add some glitter lines. There you can see it in a very nice copper rose color, or rose copper. And so next to the bubbles I'm adding a glitter line. And it's if your resin is thicker, then you don't, then it doesn't spread that much. That's why I'm using a different resin for this. Also, the link to that resin is in the description box. And don't forget, I also have a promo code of the Resin Pro company. If you use my code Petra, then you get 10% discount. And my code works on all their websites. They have a German website, French, Spanish, Italian, UK, and also Russian. So the promo code works on all their websites. So it's a nice discount. The information to it is in the description box. I think that looks nice. Yeah, now I'm adding a line of a very soft pink color, and it's a mixture of my own pigments. It's a mixture of the white lily, it's a very nice white color, and the cotton candy, but also a little bit of the Aurora pink, and that's an interference color. I'm testing that color, and I'm adding a line on the outside, and this is the sangria, because I want to have some contrast, and I want to use another technique. Some clear next to it, and also this is a thicker resin, because for this technique I want to have a thicker resin, because I'm using a stick in a minute, and drag the sangria into the clear so that I get a stripy effect. Pushing the clear against the sangria color, very nice deep red color. So if you are interested in my own natural mica pigments, I have listed them in my Etsy shop. I also added this week 4 new colors. So at the moment I'm having 52 colors. And I'm having some great discounts. So the link to my Etsy shop is in the description box. They are also available in the USA and Canada. And also there are some great discounts. And especially this week. If you order above $50, then you get a discount of 20%. It's a Labor Day sale, so that's great. So if you're interested, also that information is in the description box. So I started dragging the sangria with a stick into the clear. Then I get that stripy look that I want. But this will get several layers so that I can create the depth but also the contrast. I think this looks nice. And also next to the light pink. Some clear. Yeah, and I'm testing an Aurora red. I also have violet and pink, and no, I'm testing Aurora pink. And it's an interference color, so you can use it as is. And if you use it as is and you use it on a black surface, then you have some nice, what can you create? An opal look or another lights look. That's what you can create, but you can also add it to another pigment. If you add it to a red, for example, and you add the Aurora pink, then the red will get a pink sheen over it. But you can also make a color lighter, a lighter shade, if you add the Aurora to it. So many possibilities with the interference colors. So I'm testing them at the moment, and if I like them, then I will add them to my pigment line. So I'm going to add a little bit more of the sangria color on the outside. And so you can see the glitter lines don't spread that much. It's all because of a thicker consistency resin. And that resin, this resin, the thicker resin, has a working time of 45 minutes. So that's, for me, it's enough for a 40 centimeter surface. And also with this resin you can pour up to 1 centimeter. So it's all, you can also use it in a mold. And I must say, for a thicker resin, it doesn't have a lot of air bubbles. Because normally, if you have a thicker resin, then you have a lot of air bubbles in it. I'm adding some clear on top of the bubbles. Because I didn't do that yet, so it needs to have some resin on top of it to also seal the gilding liquid. Pushing it against my fire glass. You can see it's a nice thickness of resin. Yeah, but it's also what you prefer. I prefer a medium to a thick consistency resin. But yeah, if you like a thinner resin, then it's also okay. But yeah, I prefer a medium to thick resin. Adding more of the sangria color. Because I want to have more of this color into the white. More of those lines. Now I'm starting again to drag the sangria into the clear. There you can see it. And also, if you want to create this look, yeah, it's best to wait a little bit so that your resin will get thicker, because then the lines will, you can drag the lines much better into your clear. So it's 24 hours later, now I'm going to start on layer 3 and I want to add some glass glitter on top of the bubbles. So I'm using a nice silver pink color because I love sparkle, as you all know. So I'm adding a line on top of the bubbles. And again I'm using the Art Pro Deluxe, the thicker resin. Yeah, and to add this line, I added a little bit of the resin into the glitter, and then you can make some nice lines. Yeah, and I'm liking the stripe effect of the sangria color on top of the white. Yeah, you can't see the interference color, the Aurora pink, but at the end of this video, what I already mentioned, I'm going to show you a close-up and then you can see it much better, the color shifting. We are a little bit further in the process. I also want a glitter line on the other side, on top of the bubbles. Now I'm going to add again some gold next to the fire glass, but this time I'm going to blow it into the clear so that it will lay on top of the bubbles. So I don't want to cover it totally, but I think that will look nice if I have some gold on laying on top of the bubbles, because that way I can create some nice depth. So I'm adding some clear next to the gold, and then I'm going to blow the gold. Now you can see it. First I'm heating it up to make it more liquid, then I'm going to blow the gold into the clear. Not too much. More clear next to the glitter line. Also next to the fire glass to push that gold a little bit to the outside. And again, I'm going to add another color to the outside of this geode. And this is a mixture of three mica pigments. It's the brunette, it's a nice brown color, and the sangria to create a darker shade of red. Because I want to have some contrast, what I already mentioned, on the outside. And again, I'm dragging that color into the clear. There you can see it. So this is a combination of the brunette and the sangria. Adding more of the color. More clear. Because I need to fill this whole layer. And what I'm adding now, this is the Aurora Red. So what I said in the beginning, you can use it as is. Then you get, yeah, hopefully you will see it at the end of the video in a close-up. Then you get a nice pearly red sheen. I think that will look nice on top of the white and a little bit into the red. There you can see it again. I'm adding the Aurora Red. And so far I'm liking this pigment very much. So, yeah. I want to test it a little bit more before I will add it to my pigment line. Again, I'm adding the darker shade of red dragging the lines. Again, the Aurora Red. So in some places I'm adding this color. The torch for the air bubbles. And now I'm almost done again with this layer. Yeah, again I need to let it dry. And yeah, before I can work on it again. So we are 24 hours later again, and now I'm starting on the fourth layer. Yeah, and I want to add a dark gray color on the outside. It has no shimmer or sparkle or whatsoever. I mixed the white paste and a little bit of black paste from Resin Pro into each other. And then I got this color because this needs to resemble the stone. It always has some gray. And I also think by adding a color on the outside, a darker contrast color on the outside that has no shimmer or sparkle, you can create some nice depth. So with a stirring stick, I'm adding this color. I also draw the line where I want to have this color. And what I also didn't show is I've added some gilding lines next to the glitter line, but also on top of the bubbles. In the close-up you can see that much better, but I added it with a brush and with the same gilding liquid that I also used on the bubbles. So we are a little bit further. And again, I'm using the thicker resin, the Art Pro Deluxe. And I'm very pleased how it looks so far. And this will, of course, get a nice clear layer on top. I'm not going to show you that because I've shown you that in several other videos and it's not that difficult. So, and also then my video would be so much longer. Again, a little bit further. Now I'm working on the sides. Because also the sides will get this dark gray color. And what I did first, before I add the resin, is that I sanded the sides with a wet sandpaper grit 240, because then the resin will stick to it, and then I cleaned it, of course, with some alcohol. But then the resin will stick to the sides. Again, a little bit further in the process, working on the top side, on the sides. So all the supplies I've used in this video, I think I mentioned it earlier in the video, you can find in the description box with the links to the website. You can also find my Facebook page and Instagram page in the description box, the links to it. So if you want to follow me there, it's also possible. The link to my Etsy shop is in the description box. Also the link to the Etsy shop of my associate, Evelyn Schaefer in the USA. And so there's a lot of information. Also, all the promo codes I have for some nice discounts. So please check out the description box if you're interested. So I'm almost done. Then I need to let this dry. And then after that, I can show you all the end result. So this is the end result, and what I already mentioned, I have added a clear layer of resin, and I outlined the dark gray on the edge. I think that looks very nice. So there you can see the Aurora Red, what I mentioned, but also the nice sparkly center with the fire glass and the glass glitter. The nice gilding liquid lines, the bubbles, but also the stripy effect. There you can see again the Aurora red and pink. Yeah, I'm very pleased. Also the gold that I blow into the clear is laying on top. So I used a lot of techniques in this for making this geode. So hopefully I have inspired you all to also try out some techniques. There you see the bubbles up close with the gilding liquid on top. So all the information you want to know is in the description box. So all the links to the websites you can find there. So hopefully you liked this resin geode, and hopefully also I will see you all in the next video. Bye!